Mark, welcome to my home. This is part 8 of my upgrade series for my 2015 Tabmex S trailer, where I'm moving the water tank from inside the kitchen and the pump from inside the bathroom down underneath the trailer. Well, today we had my water tank showed up. I got this from a place called Plastic Mart. They make custom tanks. This is not a custom tank, but you basically select a tank that they have and tell them where you want the different filler necks to go, or different openings. So this is my inch and a half fill line. This is my half inch supply line, and that's my half inch vent line. So this tank is a 6 gallon tank. The original tank that was in the kitchen was 5 gallons, so this is an additional gallon. I don't expect it'll hold a whole lot more water than the other tank will, because it's flat, and if it tilts a little bit, you can lose access to some of the water. But it's narrow enough to where it will fit underneath the trailer and inside the frame rails, so it won't extend down and I won't lose any ground clearance for it. Long enough and wide enough. So we're gonna head out into the shop, and I need to, I've got some steel, angle iron, some strap steel, and I'm going to weld up a frame for this to hold it underneath the trailer. So let's go get at that. Okay, freezing cold out here. Down in front, I wanna, do my welding outside. It's better for me, healthier anyway. So there's the tank, my steel. I've got several pieces of just angle iron here. I'm gonna cut them to length and make generally with straps, with steel strap, we're going to make up a frame to hold this up underneath. So I'm going to go ahead and measure and cut, and then we'll weld it up. Should be pretty easy. See you in a bit. Okay, we have all the steel cut. There's the frame. Angle iron will go underneath. This is upside down, right? Angle iron that will screw to the bottom of the trailer, and straps and angle iron. Pretty straightforward. So we'll go ahead, clean that up, grind it, get it ready for welding. Weld it all up. Excellent. Yay, there's my frame. Mount that tank. Pretty straightforward. And it just goes on. Just like that. So we will drill holes. Lots of them here, because we need to disperse. This is heavy, it's about 50 pounds. I need to disperse that weight along a large area of the bottom as I can, the bottom of the trailer. So I'll drill holes about every 3 inches along here. We'll then put some butyl tape along the bottom and set it down in the butyl tape. That'll seal the holes where the screws go into the floor. So we go ahead and paint this, and I think we'll call it a day, because it take the while, the paint to a while to dry in this cold temperature. Anyway, guys, see you in the next one. Drive safe.
Bonus feature. There it is, all painted. Let that dry, then we'll drill holes. So anyway, We'll see in the next one where we mount this tank to the bottom of the trailer. Excellent. See you next time. Bye-bye.